And here we are at EQ Music Live with the legendary Dragonette. Hello.
Hi.
I love legendary. Don't you?
Yeah.
Try it on. Say it.
Legendary.
Or as you would say here in the UK, legendary.
Legendary.
Yeah.
Anyway. I mean, you guys are legendary. I mean, 10 years since Galore came out. Quite a milestone, actually.
Yeah. It's like we're like a heritage band at this point. It's really us, you two, Rolling Stones, I know. It's... Yeah, we're getting there, though. It's freaking awesome. I said freaking because it might be children out there. It's awesome that we still are doing this after so long. For us, like, we clearly love to do it.
I love that you said tonight that London's your sort of second home because you lived here for so many years and promoting your first music. What's it like to come back after a short breakaway?
Well, we come here a lot. Like, I do a lot of writing here with people, and it really is like I don't kind of miss a step when I'm here. Like, I don't feel like I have to get used to it. It's just I slip right back into my London life. I love it. I want to live in both Toronto and London, ideally, but I'm going to pick Toronto for now, but I'll be back.
It's cool. A lot of changes in this time. No, we were talking about how there's no A to Z anymore. We were just thinking about that. MySpace,
Uber. When we lived here, we had seven A to Zs on the...
One of them was velour bound. It was nice. Remember that one?
Yeah, I made a special one so I knew it was mine. And now they're all in the garbage.
London, what happened? What happened?
Oh, it's just Google Maps now. So Google Maps and Uber. I absolutely love, love, love that you guys played I Get Around tonight. What was it like performing that song?
What did you think? Because it was a new rendition. Was that okay with you?
That was freaking awesome for me.
Thank you. Well, I guess because when you've been playing a song for 10 years the same, it's fun to reinvent it. But sometimes that doesn't go over so well for people who've only seen you play it once 10 years ago and they want to hear the song that's on the album. But.
And came all the way from Brighton to hear it just the way it was. Yeah.
And sorry, you're out of luck because it sounds completely different now.
Well, I don't think tonight there's an unhappy soul in the audience. Definitely some diehard Dragonette.
Well, that was fun. That was a lot of fun.
Fantastic. Now, you guys have kept it unashamedly pop for so many years and never been tempted to do sort of any other genres, but why is pop music so important to you?
Well, I just think that, I don't know, I think everything's under the umbrella of pop. It's hard to not make pop music these days. Like, everything is, R&B is pop, EDM is pop. Country is pop now. Everything's kind of blended together, and I think that we make a sort of alt pop, maybe, or maybe in your opinion it's just straight up pop. I don't know, but I think it's a really fun format to write in and to be able to perform and.
Yeah, we've never actually like gone to the edge of pop and writing a song and been like, oh no, we can't do that. That's not pop. We just pretty much do whatever we want or know how to do, and it luckily fits inside that ever-increasing parameter.
A new single, Darth Vadar, coming out. Tell us a little bit about that track.
Well,
outside of the obvious.
that we love Star Wars and Daft Punk, and we put them together in one song.
That's the song came about actually in London. It was born, and then it got kind of kicked over to Toronto to be finished by Dan. But the
it actually took a year and a half to make that song. It has like
it went through a lot of versions.
There's basically like a country and western version. there are a lot of versions of that song. And in fact, I came to London. I was talking today about our friend Dan Grek, who lives around the corner, has mixed all of our records. And I was like, fuck it, I'm gonna get this song done by the time I see Dan in a week. I'm sure it'll be fine. Get to London the day before we're supposed to mix it. I'm listening to him like, I absolutely hate this version. Stayed up all night, wrote the new version, did it in a day, and it, I think, is probably the truest rendition of that song. It was basically one of the few times that we've like had to work on it. Come. How do you
feel about it? I don't know, I didn't hear it.
Yeah. Thank God I got a break from talking about Darth Vadar. Anyway, that's the next song. We've got a pretty cool idea for a video, which like I'm hesitant to talk about only because it depends on so many people that we don't know. But if it happens, it'll be a pretty cool thing too.
Fantastic. It's like, well, thank you so much, Dragonette, for doing this show tonight. We're so humbled that you played our little stage. And any parting words for EQ Music blog reader?
Oh, gosh.
Don't do too many drugs.
Or some.
To music.
Yeah. Only some drugs. Why the drugs?
Well, it's like advice you give, like stay straight, stay in school.
Stay in school until it's boring, yeah. And then leave it.
The end.
And there you heard it from Dragonette. Thanks, guys.